Once we feel there's a need for a South African or a Cape Harvest Festival, then it has to be echt, authentically Cape. So what we are celebrating here is the music and the language and the cuisine and the cultural landscape of the Cape. The core of this Harvest Festival is the wine farm workers themselves, the people who've toiled in the vineyards and in the cellar. The workers that feel it belongs to them, they know this is our culture, this is our farm, this is our party. And what's exciting about the Cape is the real story of the pre-colonial people, the early settlers, the slave period, apartheid, all of the pain and the tribulations of that period is what's made us the people that we are today. Why should we go about doing things this way? What's in it for us? Nothing is going to work if there isn't self-interest, you know. I think that people are naturally going to first and foremost look after their own survival. For our own sake, the South Africa as an economy, as a tourist destination, as a wine industry, etc., it's not sustainable unless we address these issues, you know. That unless those of us who are in the privileged position that we are as a result of all of this, unless we do something to acknowledge that and to change it, not because of ideological reasons or because of moral reasons, but just because it can't survive unless we do, unless we actually recognize it can't stay the same as it was. Having done it the way that I've done it, what's happened is I have the best employer-employee relationships imaginable. You know, we have the team on this farm are all pulling in the same direction because we're all on the same side, because we're all benefiting from this place. We like each other, we enjoy each other's company, we have parties like this for that reason. If you do what's right, the rewards come to you. They come to you yourself too. I've lost nothing by sharing this place. I've only gained from it.